Before we get into the video, up on the screen right now is a picture of the watch time from subscribers and non-subscribers. And as you can see, most of you watching this video aren't subscribed. So if you haven't yet, please drop a sub. It's free. It takes 2 seconds. And hey, if you regret your decision, you can, you know, unsubscribe later. If you don't like the content, you can do that. So just please drop a sub. Without further ado, let's get into this video. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. My name is Valente, and we are back with the fourth and final mock draft of the 2024 draft season. As you can see at the bottom right corner of your screen, it is April 24th. It's 4:33 a.m. also, but it is April 24th, 2024, which is exactly 1 day before the NFL draft. And yeah, we're gonna put together the best mock draft you've ever seen, hopefully. So yeah, without further ado, let's get straight into this. We're gonna look at all the picks above us. All right, boom. So boom, we are going to keep this trade in mind because we might take it anyway. Moving on, we're gonna start here up at the top. Caleb Williams to the Bears, the worst kept secret in the NFL. Drake May, Jaden Daniels, Marvin to the Cardinals, Malik Nabers, Joel to the Giants, Olu to the Titans, Roma Dunze to the Falcons, Liatu Latu to the Bears, it's a good pick. Talis Fuaga to the Jets, JJ McCarthy to the Vikings, Brock Bowers to the Broncos, and Terrion Arnold to the Raiders. Now, a lot of the times we do a draft, there is one of Brock Bowers, Olu, Talis Fuaga, and stuff like that here. However, there are some people that I like in this. You got Dallas Turner, who could be your long-term Cam Jordan replacement. However, I don't think I want to do that right now. I like the idea of trading back. That is something the Saints have not done since 2007. I just figured out today. So we have a couple of trade offers here. I really like this one. I don't like the fact that we're not getting a first next year. And then we have this one, which really isn't that great. So we're going to take a look at this one right here. I'm going to counter. We're going to take 73 out. And then we're going to try and get a first next year. We really don't know if Detroit's going to be super good or bad. They're probably not going to be bad. They're probably not going to win the Super Bowl. Though they could make the playoffs. There's a chance they don't. It's probably going to be a later round pick, but it is an extra first round pick. So we're gonna try 3, 2, 1, boom. Boom. Okay, we got rejected. Trade offer, let's counter this again. So let's take 73 out and we'll add 190. So we're gonna get their first next year. Pick 29 this year. They get 14, 150, and 190, and then we take 29. 61, their first next year, and their second next year. You're trading up damn near more than what the gap is between us. So you should take this. No? Okay. Looks like we're gonna sit exactly where we're at because this is stingy as hell. There's a couple of guys that I like here. Troy Fatano would be one that I'd take if we're looking for tackle. Dallas Turner is a good one because he's a edge that I honestly would have expected the Falcons to take. We could have probably traded up a little bit. I don't like the idea of us trading up this year though. Historically it doesn't work out more for us than it does. And usually we get fleeced by the other team's GM, and I do not think that I do not think that Mickey Loomis is physically fit and mentally fit to run a football organization anymore. However, we're here. I'm probably going to go with Dallas Turner here because I believe Dallas Turner is your long-term replacement option for Cam Jordan. I wish, you know what, actually, screw that. We're going to try something. Bengals. Let's trade back with the Bengals. They get 14, we get 18. We get their first next year. We get 80. They get 190. And fuck it, let's take their third next year too. 18, 80, their first next year, and their third next year, four, pick 14, and pick 190. Let's try it. Nope. All right, I'm going to do one more. Let's try Jacksonville. So we'll give them 14. We'll take 17. We'll give them 150. We'll take 96. And a first next year. Let's just try not to be too stingy. Let's walk out of there with more draft capital. Boom. Trade's been rejected. See, Pro Football Network, you might want to update this because I don't know anybody who would not take that trade. Alright, well, we're going to pick here between these three guys. We're going to go with either Dallas Turner, Jared Verse, or Troy Fatanu. I'm going to immediately eliminate Jared Verse only because Dallas Turner is the better option. Troy Fatanu would help out our need at left tackle. I believe he plays left tackle. He would indefinitely help out one of our tackle spots that we need. And, you know, once you get a solid tackle, your offensive line looks a lot better than what it is right now. I think that's something you could address later in the draft, maybe at pick 45. So while we have this, I wouldn't say damn near generational, but I'd say while we have this potential all-pro sitting right in front of our face, we're going to take Dallas Turner. I believe that solidifies your edge rusher room, if you want to call it that. You know, you'll have a Cam Jordan who could whip someone like him into shape. You know, teach him all of the things about the NFL. And hopefully get him ready to take over, because I know Cam knows his days are numbered, and that sounds really bad, but... Oh, look at this! Pick four. Okay, first of all, we're going to keep this here just because I see that first round pick. But we're going to take a look at what's here and what we could potentially get. Here's where I'd want to take a tackle. If there is not a super tackle, or not a super tackle, but a really good tackle here, I would potentially want to move back a little bit. Here's the thing. Are you willing to eat a potentially bad year to take this offer right here? Because, by the way, this is a steal. You have the Seattle's first. You know, if they don't make the playoffs, that's a top 17-ish pick. You know, they're kind of on the border between playoff and not right now. Or do you take someone like Patrick Paul and... or Roger Rosengarten here. You know what? I'm going to take this offer right here. This is going to be the first trade offer we accept in our mock draft. So yeah, we traded down to 81. We gave them 45 and I forgot the other pick. I think it was 190 for 81, another pick, and then their first next year. Miami is offering a 2025 draft haul here. That would be something that I'm not really willing to accept, just because it's about time we make a fucking pick here. All right, reject these. So, we're going to go back to all. We got our edge rusher. Junior Colson would be a good pick. It's something I don't think I'm really interested in right now. Ricky Pearsall is a big body, not a big body, but a big name, not big body. But he is a big name in this draft. The Saints like their super athletic guys, we know that. As you see here, he's got some great route running ability, elite body control, great hand strength, and great against the press. Yeah, I mean, Ricky Pearsall wouldn't be a super bad pick here. So we're gonna take the guy Ricky Pearsall from Florida, add another body to that receiving room that kind of needs help. I wouldn't say desperately, but it has its moments. Braylon Allen, I'm gonna take him here. Braylon Allen is, in my eyes, running back one in this draft class. I don't know if any running back was taken before him. Bucky Irving. Braylon Allen is a top dog. And you're looking for your like running back of the future because Kamara is, I believe, on the last year of his deal or in the last 2 years of his deal. And you could build up Braylon Allen, and I'm pretty sure, yeah, this dude is a tank of a human. And he's only going to be 20 as a rookie, so you have a lot of development opportunities with him, going into his next 2 to 3 years. So yeah, we're going to draft Braylon Allen here at the top of the fourth round. Right, we are at pick 150 next. And you know what? While I still got you guys here, I just want to thank you all so much from the bottom of my heart for 100 subscribers, because my goal was to hit that by the end of April and you guys shattered that goal. So I appreciate you all so much, more than you will ever know. And I'm gonna keep pushing out content for you all because y'all are amazing and I greatly appreciate it. Now, here at 150, we can look back at we really still need that tackle, don't we? Yeah, so we really still need that tackle. Javon Foster is here. Garrett Greenfield, I like both of those guys. I think Garrett Greenfield is a athletic freak, according to his RAS score. Javon Foster's not really the guy to go to when it comes to athleticism. I'm going to hope that one of these two are still there. With the next pick, we're gonna take a look at defensive tackle. Jordan Jefferson's here. He is. I don't really know too much about him, so I'm not gonna speak on him. Let's see, safety. We potentially, build some depth here. Depth, not death. What am I on? What about guard? Guard. Javion Cohen there, yep. Layden Robinson. What about center? Jerick Nugent, you could push him out the guard. I like him. Running back. No, we just took one. You know what? We're gonna look at. Let's take a look at D tackle. You know what? I don't know too much about Jordan Jefferson. I'm not even gonna sit here and lie to y'all. We're gonna take Jordan Jefferson here just because of where he's ranked. I'm not gonna sit here and try and tell you a load of bullshit. So yeah, here we are at 168. Are one of our tackles still there? They are both still there. Personally, I know the Saints like their athletic guys. I can see that Garrett Greenfield is a heck of a lot more athletic than Juwan Foster. So we're gonna take him. Why not? This seems like a realistic thing. I think, the Saints would probably be the only team in the history of ever not to accept a first round pick during the second round trading. So who knows? Here at 175, Quantes Stiggers from the CFL. I didn't know you could get drafted from the CFL. That's cool. Let's take a look at corner. Quantes is there. Tarvis still. Where's Jarvis Brownlee? I assume that Jarvis Brownlee was taken. That's my guy, Jarvis Brownlee. D tackle. We didn't take a D tackle, did we? Yeah, we did. Of course, we did. Tight end is Jaheim Bell still here? Eric All, I like Eric All. I like Brevin Spanford. We can wait a little bit for that. Another receiver wouldn't be bad. I like Cornelius Johnson out of Michigan. He is an athletic freak as well, at least according to the RIS. He could have been somebody that was buried behind other receivers like Roman Wilson. The Saints are due to take a quarterback in the 5th or 6th round, I assume. Maybe another offensive tackle. Javon Foster's still here. Back-to-back tackles. One of them's got to be good, right? 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 Javon Foster's the pick. Moving on to 190. We're still in the 6th round. You know what? It's the Saints. They're going to take a quarterback. Who do we got still here with us? Oh, my God. Jack Plummer. No, not Jack Plummer. You know what? We're going to take the guy, Joe Milton, the 3rd. At the worst, you have a guy who can throw end zone to end zone. Could potentially be your backup or your backup's backup. Or your emergency 3rd QB. He's not bad. Or you can try and turn him into a Taysom Hill type guy. I've watched a decent bit of film on Joe Milton, and he is a very physical runner in terms of he's not really afraid to take a hit. So you could turn him into your Taysom Hill type guy whenever Taysom decides to hang up the cleats. So we're going to draft Joe Milton because, even though I didn't mention it, this is the most realistic Saints mock draft you have ever seen. Moving on. Let's take a look at tight ends. I like Brevin Spanford. I'm going to reach on Brevin Spanford because I like him so much. All right, moving on into the 7th round, pick 239. I believe this is our last pick of the draft. And if you guys have watched every other mock draft that I've done this season, you would know more than anything else, you cannot go through a mock draft, especially if you're a Saints fan, and not draft the guy Tory Taylor. I would like a guy who could flip the field when it comes to punting. I would like a guy who could have a higher average than 38 yards a punt, and Tory Taylor punts a lot more than this guy and than Lou Headley. So why not take Tory Taylor? Tory Taylor is a dog of a punter. And as far as I know, he doesn't have any allegations with him, so you don't gotta meta-rise a guy. So, now we are here. Mock draft done. Final mock draft of the season. Let's run by it again. Dallas Turner. Again, that is somebody that if he's there, you're going to take to be like your future all-pro, your future Cam Jordan replacement. You know, it's hard to fill the shoes of Cam Jordan. But Dallas Turner is a guy that can do that. He's not a project guy like other guy you picked at 14 about approximately 6 years ago. Ricky Pearsall is an extra body to put in the receiving room. You could put him at wide receiver 3, wide receiver 4, let him develop a little bit, whatever you want to do with that. Braylon Allen is one of the best running back prospects. Probably the best running back prospect in this draft class. I like Braylon Allen a lot. He is only 20 years old. He's not even 20 yet, I don't think. He's 19. He'll be 20 in his rookie season. You have a lot of ways to develop him. You have a lot of time to develop him. Braylon Allen at 102. Jordan Jefferson, like I said, I'm not going to sit here and lie to y'all. I do not know shit about him. If you guys watch me and you're LSU fans, you might be able to help me out with that. Is picking him at 150 justified? Let me know in the comments below. 168, we got Garrett Greenfield. He is the athletic tackle out of South Dakota State. And I figured, if this one doesn't work out, let's just pick another one 7 picks later. Juwan Foster out of Missouri. I don't know too much about either of them other than the RAS scores, like I just saw. Joe Milton out of 190. At this point, let's be honest, the Saints have taken a quarterback in every draft for the last 4 years. Ian Book, Jake Haener. Tommy Stevens, who's 2022? Was that Ian Book or was that 2023? 2023 was Jake Hayner. 2022 was Ian Book. 2021 was Ian Book. 2022. Either way, the Saints like to take a quarterback in the draft for absolutely no fucking reason. 190, we take Joe Milton at the worst. He could be a Taysom Hill guy, maybe. Who knows? I really like Brevin Spanford. I think he is a heavily underrated tight end prospect in the 2024 class. And hey, could be an extra big body pass catcher that the Saints are looking for. Maybe. We'll see. And then, of course, like I said, you cannot do a Saints mock draft without taking Torrey Taylor. You guys, if you watched last season, you watched with Hadley punt. We're going to punt a lot. It's just who we are. If you watched with Hadley punt, you know that man is god-awful. Torrey Taylor is an incredible pick. He would do wonders for our special teams. I'm pretty sure Darren Rizzi is salivating over this guy. So yeah, and then we also got a 2025 Seattle first round pick out of that. I can't use it, but if the Saints would actually pull that off, that'd be super nice. Especially if the Seattle Seahawks just come out of nowhere and suck. Then you have a potential top pick next year. And if you suck, you have two top picks next year. So yeah. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Thank you all for joining me again. Thank you all for 100 subscribers. I hope to achieve many more with you guys. And hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you drop a like, subscribe, turn on those notifications for all future Saints content. And if you made it to the end of the video, comment pineapple. Why? I don't know. But also another announcement if you have made it to the end of the video. I'm going to be live for the draft every day of the draft. Maybe not Saturday, but Thursday or tomorrow technically, and Friday I'm gonna be live for those 2 days. So if you guys want to check out that, you know, hang out with me and watch the draft and see my live reactions to hopefully not a terrible Saints pick, feel free to join me. But yeah, with that all being said, that's gonna be it. I'll see you guys on draft day. Peace.